say is wow. I am blown away by the support that this event has been given. Thanks firstly to each and every one of you for buying a ticket and spending your Saturday night with us. Simply by buying a ticket, you have made a difference. I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge the Cammeraygal people who are the traditional custodians of this land, and I pay respect to the elders past and present. My name is Linda, and I welcome you to the Liverity Spring Fashion Show. Liverity was born almost exactly 1 year ago. It was a fleeting thought that came into my mind, and I knew I just had to make it happen. Liverity, it's a made-up word based loosely on life and truth. It quickly gained momentum with a handful of people volunteering to help, maybe not realising what they were signing up for. But here we are, a year later, and thanks to all those people, our vision has become reality. Tonight could not have been achieved without the support and tireless work of many people. People who gave their talents, enthusiasm and time, lots of it, to bring this to life. I'll say more about these special people at the end of the show. Tonight is about the big C. C for celebration. 12 brave women and men will be on our catwalk tonight. They each have a story and they each have a reason to celebrate. Tonight is in their honour. These 12 women and men are symbolic of the countless hundreds and thousands of people each day who have a similar story. I think you'll agree with me when I say it takes guts to get on a catwalk. And as the old saying goes, no guts, no glory. Well, tonight is time for a bit of glory. Our models have embraced Liverity. They have rehearsed, tried on many different outfits, laughed along the way, and most importantly, they seem to have a lot of fun. And now, I'd like to introduce our MC for this evening. Erin Molan is a presenter on Channel 9, where she is currently the weekend news sports presenter, Friday Night Footy NRL host, host of the Sunday Footy Show, and host of primetime entertainment program 20 to 1. She's also the co-host of Weekend Afternoons on Australia's number one talkback radio station 2GB, and a key part of the legendary Continuous Call team. Erin has been extensively involved with radio in Sydney and Brisbane and became the first female full-time member of 2GB's Continuous Call team. She's a proud ambassador for a number of charities, including Save Our Sons, the Sydney to Canberra bike ride and the Culture Break. But it's her work with Bowel Cancer Australia that has resulted in unprecedented awareness of Australia's second most deadly cancer. She also spends time mentoring and engaging with young women. These days, Erin calls Sydney home, but she remains a passionate Canberra Raiders supporter. Outside of work and sport, she maintains an interest in fashion. That's lucky. Politics, the Indonesian language, and Indonesian affairs. But above all, she's a mum to Eliza, who just turned one. I am so grateful to Erin for giving her time to us tonight. She has literally come off the news bench on Channel 9 Sports News and raced over here for this. So I'm so grateful. Thank you, Erin. Please welcome her.
Thank you very much and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is a real honour to be here. I promise you, I'm absolutely blown away. Exactly the same as Linda, I'd kind of envisaged something a little bit smaller, and I just think this is testament to all the work that she has done. And just before we get underway, I wanted to talk just a little bit about, I guess, why I wanted to help out tonight and why I think this is a really worthy cause. I'm an ambassador for Bowel Cancer Australia. My big sister was 27 when she was diagnosed with stage 3/4 bowel cancer. She was pregnant and she'd noticed changes in her body, but she'd written them off as symptoms of pregnancy. As you know, anyone who's carried a child will understand that your body changes dramatically. She kept going to doctors and they would say, you might have a wheat intolerance, you know, try cutting out gluten, those kind of things. Eventually she went to a doctor who said, we need to look a little bit further. And I think we were probably about a month away from it being a really different outcome. She went straight into surgery. They removed her entire bowel. She's still got a colostomy bag today. She had chemo radiation, but she's still here today. And it's something that we sat down and spoke about afterwards. And we thought, if we can do anything to try and get other families the same outcome that we've had, and that is absolutely blessed to still have our sister here, then we will do everything in our power. And it's my main driving force, to be honest, in everything I do, is to raise awareness, not just of raise awareness, not just of bowel cancer, but of all cancers, because bowel cancer specifically, it's the second biggest cancer killer in Australia, but it's got the best cure rate. Over 90% of cases can be cured if they're detected early. So raising awareness is so crucial, so key. The other part of Sarah's story is she was living out in rural Australia in Swan Hill in Victoria. So not only did she receive a diagnosis that at 27 years old as a young mum was absolutely terrifying, the C word, as we know, the negative part of the C word, not celebration, but cancer. She was also living in a little country town, in fact, not even Swan Hill, but Nia, which is just outside of Swan Hill. So the challenge of travelling to Melbourne for treatment was intense. She didn't earn a lot of money. Her husband didn't earn a lot of money. They had two kids already and had to take time off work, and it was really, really tough. So charities like CanAssist are so crucial to people doing it tough, because when you are diagnosed with cancer, you should not have to worry about money. And that's what charities like this do. So thank you so much for the work that you guys do. And thank you all so very much for coming here tonight. It's incredible to see the support, and I cannot wait to see the show that we're in for this evening. Now, I don't know if you heard, but Victoria's Secret has cancelled this year because of a lack of body diversity. So word on the street is there are scouts embedded within you. And potentially they may be looking at replacing it with something a little local, a little closer to home. So the pressure's on, ladies and gentlemen, behind the scenes. Probably just added a lot more pressure to you. Now, a few housekeeping bits before we begin. No flash photography. You've all Googled and YouTubed where models fall over. It's very funny. We don't want that to happen to our models here tonight, because they are not professionals. Now, there will also be a chance, of course, afterwards for family and friends to take as many photos as you like. And of course, and I know I probably don't even need to say this, but these ladies and gentlemen are not professional models, so they will be trying their best. So please support them in every single way you can, because this takes a lot of courage to do what they're about to do. And they need all of our support. So ladies and gentlemen, let's kick it off. A big round of applause and let's get things underway. Relaxed, that's one way to put it. Very sexy, my friend, and beautiful in this silky two-piece sleepwear from Bella Cove Lingerie. You wear that very well. Are you single, Imelda? Not for me, obviously. Now, Catherine's outfit by The Arc can be dressed up or down. It's the perfect travel piece, easy to pack and easy to wear, available from The Found. And Julie is ready to take on the day in this fun and stylish outfit. From Fuchsia Boutique, Julie is wearing the world's best-selling swing top by Joseph Rickoff in Jacaranda. And that's Fuchsia Boutique. Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for our first group. Well done, ladies. Oh, wow. Elle McPherson's got nothing on you guys. Well, we have those legs. Stop it.
Sneakers, stop it.
You fashion-forward guru. Now, this outfit is fun, casual, yet loaded with style. Now, Sarah, she's ready for anything the day will throw at her in this very stylish short suit by Arlington Milne, available soon at The Hunted. Girl, you look 20. Stop it. That's amazing. Now, Sherelle, your smile has lit up the entire room. You look stunning in this classic daytime outfit from Taking Shape. A long trench is this season's hot colour, takes this outfit to a whole new level. You look amazing. Well done. And John, you either look Polish or polished. Are you from Poland? Okay, you look polished and you're ready for a day at the polo in MJ Bale. You go, John, you got this, work it. Well done, all of you, brilliant, looking amazing. I'm hoping they come out soon because I've just been asked to sing. I don't know if anyone heard the continuous call team today. I did try singing, it didn't go down well. A round of applause if you're family of the models. What about if you're friends? And raise your hand if you think, I'm trying to think of who's a model that would be relatable, like Giselle. If you think our models are hotter than Giselle. I think she was like 10 years ago, so I'm not very modern. Is it the Hadids? Is that who the hot ones are? These like Gigi and Bella? I'm still kind of like Elle McPherson and that era, I think. But look, it is honestly a really wonderful occasion here tonight, and I'm going through and telling you what all our wonderful models are wearing. And I guess what I'm trying to say is if you can support the incredible companies that have supported this event tonight, please do, because they do it without any expectation, without any guarantee of support. But all the sponsors that Linda read out earlier, and I'm sure you'll go through them again at the end, please support them, because events like this don't occur without the support of wonderful people giving up their time and giving up their products. So please go and shop in these clothes stores and support all of the companies that have supported us. And support this school. I mean, if you don't have children, have some and send them to this school. You're welcome. Hopefully, as I sit down now, the parade will start again. Anymore, is it? I've got to find a new place as well. All available at Fuchsia Boutique. Another round of applause. You all look amazing.
Take the opportunity to thank everyone in this room for their support. As Erin said, I'm Emma Phillips and I'm the Executive Director of CanAssist. And on behalf of our board, our branch volunteers and the patients that we help, I thank you for your time and your generosity. What a fabulous, uplifting night in so many ways. Like demonstrated tonight, volunteers and community support are the cornerstones of our charity and allow CanAssist to help lift the burden of a cancer diagnosis placed on a rural patient. Helping at the time of need, we assist anyone of any age with any cancer. Unfortunately, the further you live away from Sydney, the statistics worsen regarding a person's access to treatment and survival. How do we help, you may ask? Well, that $50 raffle ticket tonight may be used to pay for a meal voucher, ensuring a family still eats if the family breadwinner is unable to work. Or perhaps pays the telephone bill of a young tumour mum who has breast cancer, and so she keeps in touch with her three young children who she can't see for 6 weeks because she's staying in our Wagga accommodation facility. As a one-way trip home took at least an hour and a half, and as she's having her daily treatments, that's just not feasible to get there and back. Or $350 covers a green slip, and this kept a Molong couple in their car on the road as the gentleman had to go to treatment in Sydney, 292 kilometres away, or 4 hours one way. Our charity began in 1955, actually in the eastern suburbs of Sydney, so it's great to have something on this side of the bridge. It started by Mrs. Mona Hamm, who saw the loneliness and the financial burden placed upon country cancer patients as they were sitting lonely in the hallways of Sydney Hospital between treatments. She and a group of like-minded volunteers rallied together, initially simply sharing a cup of tea and a conversation. And now a branch network of support across New South Wales has been spawned and tipping over into the boundaries of Victoria and Queensland. Our volunteer branch network raises money to support their local communities. From what I read about Mona, she was a strong and committed lady, selfless in her aims. And that is exactly what I see in Linda, my gorgeous girlfriend, the host and facilitator of this evening. Linda turned her own health situation to be empowering and giving. She's pulled together a formidable group of volunteers and embarked on making her vision a reality. Community, empowerment, and spirit. Thank you, Linda. Not only on behalf of CanAssist, but I think rightfully on behalf of the team involved tonight and those who bought a ticket. Your energy has brought us together, showcased not only what Lane Cove can provide in spring fashion, hair, and makeup, but in support. Also, for the spirit that you've allowed our models to show. And whilst I'm delighted, ecstatic, freaked out, amazed to tell you that we have raised over $24,000 tonight. I also think in so many priceless ways, it's delivered.
Wow. What a finale. Now, Paulette's dress is a great take on boho chic. This dress is perfect for a lunch date and can be found at Iris and Lynn. Accessories are also from Iris and Lynn. Paulette is wearing her own vintage Texan boots. Looking absolutely amazing. Now, John will be the best dressed man at any special occasion in his perfectly appointed suit from MJ Bale. Blue and pink paired together to give John a stylish and contemporary look. Look at that, doesn't he wear it well? Now, Sarah continues to share the beautiful collection from Arlington Mill. And this statement piece is sure to stand out in a crowd and is a perfect summer party ensemble available soon from The Hunted. How amazing does that look? This garment has been handcrafted from all natural materials by Firefly Flowers. Firefly is a passion of Karina Radu, one of our models. The amazing floral arbor that I am standing right under has also been made by Karina. Caroline is also wearing a pure silk slip from Bella Cove Lingerie. Wow, that's a lot of talent. Incredible. Now, Karina is ready for a night out for dinner or a show. These new season white stretch jeans, very flattering top and embellished clutch are all available from Blue Illusion. They look amazing. Now, Gail has her holiday outfit all picked out, a floaty and feminine fine floral print dress worn with white leather slides, wide-brimmed ivory straw hat and well, where's the straw hat? don't say I've gone the beads again. I'm off on a tangent. Now, the earrings are lovely as well. They're fabulous, white beaded circle earrings. Gorgeous outfit will be landing in Zhuzh stores in November, just in time for the party season. Now, Imelda looks striking in this stunning flared dress from Blue Illusion. It's made of French linen and available now in store. This gorgeous dress has been paired, here they are, with the beaded necklace. We found it. Hurrah! Well done, Imelda. And a stunning embellished bag. Now, Sherelle looks classic and sophisticated in her outfit from Taking Shape. Sherelle wears basic black pants and a sheer stretchy black top which could be worn at the office. This vibrant, embellished blue and green coat will transition her perfectly to a night out after work. Those colours are divine. Now, Catherine is wearing a soft flowing dress by Verge. This dress can also be worn as a jacket over pants, very versatile. And Catherine's dress, shoes and accessories are available from Found. And Fascinator are available at Fuchsia Boutique. You are onto a winner there, hey! And the confidence to boot. Now, Debbie is wearing statement palazzo pants by Trelease Cooper, paired with a vibrant emerald cami and an organza crop jacket. This outfit is available from Adam Larissa and is perfect for a special event or an evening out. Doesn't that go beautifully together? And finally, David. David brings a touch of Tom Ford sophistication and class in this chic tuxedo from MJ Bale. Now, I think Daniel Craig's in his last ever Bond, so I think potentially you're in with a chance. That is absolutely awesome. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if we could please again give a massive round of applause to all of our sensational models. They have been absolute superstars here tonight. And we've raised so far $24,000. That is next level incredible. But I tell you what is better, and that's a look on all of your faces and look on the faces of the people that love and care about you. There's been so many tears in the crowd and pride looking up at how amazing you all are. I do this for a living, stand up in front of people. And every day I meet people who I interview or do things with on live TV, and it is a terrifying thing to do. And you all look like you've been doing it for 20 years. Honestly, I'm not even being polite. You are amazing. Well done. Congratulations. And thank you so very much for having me as part of it. It's been truly an honour. Well done. Congratulations.
Before we draw the raffles, I've got a few important thank yous, if you don't mind indulging me a little. I'd like to thank Luca, who is up at NASA Space Station Control Tower, making sure all the lighting, audio, amazing job. I'd like to thank Kat from Lunar Media Productions. I've never met Kat before. 2 days ago, he and his wife contacted us and said, we'd like to be part of this, and could I film your show for free? And I was like, hell yeah. Thanks to Richard, the facilities man from Monty, who set everything up. My husband, Mark, the photographer, always a supporter of mine, never stands in my way. I love you, wherever you are. I also want to thank the many volunteers backstage. That all seems like a calm curtain. Behind there, it's chaos, I'm sure. But there's scores of people back there, the hairdressers, the makeup artists. Every model had an assistant to make sure they could get dressed and undressed in time. So thank you to all of them. They're all volunteers. And then in my earlier speech, I mentioned the few special people that I really wanted to single out. Those people have been with me on this journey every single step of the way, and there's no way this could have happened without them. So could I please ask for Anne Cunningham, Tracy Hodge, Prue Carroll, Kim Walters, and Sally Bruce, can you please join me, please, down here? And Emma Phillips, who's already here.
Everybody, good night. No, it's not good night. Sorry. I would just like everyone to put their hands together towards for Linda. And on behalf of everybody, Linda, thank you.